What's up, Beeks? This is Michael from Technically Beekeeping. It's a cold day in the apiary, not a whole lot to do here. But let's talk about the color red. Why is this color important? Also, how do we use it here in the apiary? And then lastly, how do parasites use this color? I think you'll be surprised.
So bees can't see the color red. And that's going to come off very strange to us as humans because we use the color all the time. The human eye is capable of seeing red, green, and blue. In the tech field, we call it RGB. We build our technology like monitors in that wavelength. We call it visible light, but in reality, it's human visible light. Similar to humans, bees see in three different colors. Instead of the red spectrum, they're able to see in the ultraviolet spectrum, which means that they're skewed from the red spectrum over to the ultraviolet spectrum. It allows them to be able to forage much more efficiently for pollen and nectar. In the description below, I'll put some links for UV images that you can see. So what does all this have to do with beekeeping, and how can a beekeeper use the color red? Well, when I go out to the bee yard at night, I use a red LED in order to be able to see things in the bee yard that the bees aren't able to see. If I were to use a full spectrum light like this one, what you oftentimes see is the bees will come up and they'll hit the light, similar to a moth to a flame, different principle, but they're able to see all of the different spectrums of light. Another tool that I use is a floodlight with a red bulb, and that allows me to be able to walk around the apiary hands-free, be able to move things around without having something in my hands like a flashlight. It just makes things a little easier. So I'll show you some video here from my backyard apiary.
Beeks, this is obviously not the best weather for me to show this to you. It's currently -8 here in Chicago. And in the future, I'll open the beehive up, be able to show you how the colony reacts to different types of light. And I'll do that in a future video, probably in the summer. But for now, I'll just show you the tools of the trade and how it works. So you can see that I'm using my flashlight here at dusk. You can see that the flashlight has a nice feature of being able to go wider, go shorter, which is really kind of cool. And then I can approach the apiary that's over there, just undetected from the bees. Obviously, in this cold weather, they don't really care because they're in their hive and nothing's going to be getting them out of there in this kind of weather. But up there you can see the floodlight that I told you about, and I have it on a switch where I'm able to turn it on and off. Technically could probably keep it on all the time. The bees wouldn't mind, but obviously the neighbors would.
So I'm thinking back to a conversation that I had with Dr. Peck, who is the director of research at Better Bee. He mentioned to me that, have you ever thought about the fact that the varroa mite is actually a reddish brown color? He emphasized the word reddish. And when he told me that, it really just blew my mind because I thought to myself, oh my God, the mite is actually camouflaged from the bee. This is the power of using the color red. Imagine for a minute that I had a mite on my body or a parasite that was about this big. And instead of being in the red spectrum, it was in the ultraviolet spectrum. It would be almost invisible to me, if not invisible. And I think that that's the power that the varroa mite has over the honeybee. Honestly, I suspect it's also not a coincidence that the triple elapsed mite is also a reddish brown color. If you haven't heard of this mite before, it's currently in Asia. And from all indications, it looks like it's going to be as bad, if not worse, than the varroa mite if it comes to the Western world. If you're curious about other threats that are coming here to the United States, take a look at my video up here on the Asian hornet. I think you'll find it very interesting. And if you've gotten value out of this video, please like and subscribe.